described and captioned media program. In the classroom and on the go. DCMP.org.
Human Relations Media presents Mind-Body Connection, How Your Emotions Affect Your Health. Horizontal bars gives way to images of people.
I've always had problems with anxiety. I think emotional factors affect me physically to a great deal.
My body was speaking to me, telling me that I was ignoring red flags. It's another way of your body saying, listen, there's something toxic in your life.
Scenes between the images are blurry.
With depression, just your mind and your body are kind of feel detached. And it wasn't until I was figuring out ways to reattach the two together that helped me get on the right track.
When I am exercising, I get this release. It's a sense of being one with my body and my emotions.
A young woman holds a yoga pose.
The mind and body are connected, have always been connected. Our mind is embedded in our body. Our body is interacting with our mind at all times.
Against the background of the blurred scenes, title in yellow, The Mind-Body Connection, How Your Emotions Affect Your Health. A young female host stands against an off-white background.
People used to believe that physical and emotional health were separate. They thought emotional problems such as anxiety and depression were different and distinct from physical ailments and disease. One set of problems resided in the mind and the other in the body. Today we know that physical health and emotional health are very closely connected. In this program, we will hear from several young people who have dealt with both emotional and physical problems. We'll also hear from Dr. John Rady, a psychiatrist, and Dr. Peter Montmidi, a clinical psychologist. To start, we'll look at the center of our emotions, the brain.
Title, The Mind and the Brain, Montmini.
The mind and body are connected, have always been connected. Where's the mind? In the brain. Where's the brain? In the body.
The human brain is amazingly complex. It consists of over 100 billion nerve cells called neurons that transmit signals throughout the body. Neurons send signals to each other with the help of chemicals called neurotransmitters. These neurotransmitters are essential in determining how our minds experience the world. The neurotransmitters dopamine and serotonin, for example, are associated with joyful emotions, but an imbalance or deficit of these chemicals can lead to feelings of sadness and depression.
Well, the emotions are really the intersection between the mind and body. There's certainly a biological component to our emotional difficulties, such as anxiety and depression. Always in part, all of our emotions, of course, are biologically based. We experience them through the biochemistry of our brain and the workings of our brain.
The described and captioned media program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a set of guidelines for adding descriptions and captions to media. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.